Some sort of meat in the last 3 days. So unless you're vegan or vegetarian, you probably eat on a regular basis. So it's a pretty big part of our lives. Now imagine if one day we couldn't eat any meat because of an allergic reaction. So today I'm going to be talking about a new type of food allergy. So just a quick background on allergies. So allergies are pretty common. It affects about 15 million people in the US, 30% of adults, and 40% of all children. And basically what an allergy is it's when our body reacts to a foreign substance, and this is called anaphylaxis. And some of the symptoms of anaphylaxis include hives, rashes, swelling, asthma, nausea, and so how does our immune system work? So basically our immune system causes these allergic reactions, and they're made up of these antibodies that are produced by white blood cells. And what these antibodies do is that they combine to specific antigens, which are different substances, and when this happens, it leads to anaphylaxis. So far, any questions? So my paper was the relevance of tick bites to the production of IgE antibodies to the mammalian oligosaccharide alpha-gal. And so originally, they were actually researching a cancer drug. So in 2005, a cancer drug called cetuximab was approved for immunotherapy treatment. And however, when they were administering this drug, they found that 20% of patients were having an anaphylactic reaction to this drug. And another interesting thing was that the cases were only reported in a specific portion of the United States, right here. So, turns out the reactions were occurring because patients had specific antibodies for a region of the drug. And this also happened to correspond to alpha-gal, which is a carbohydrate found in animal cells, in mammal cells. And so scientists were wondering what's happening, so they began to look at a population and analyzing their human sera for what kind of antibodies they had in their system. And so they found that when people had antibodies to alpha-gal or cetuximab, they had cetuximab-related anaphylaxis, which is an allergic reaction. But they also found that alpha-gal was also linked to anaphylaxis after consuming red meat. So this was something new, and scientists didn't actually know what was going on, so they decided to look further, because some sort of exposure was causing this production of antibodies, but they didn't know what. So they wondered what was causing this food allergy. So the first thing they looked at were tapeworms, and there wasn't really much evidence saying that tickworms could be involved, so they threw that out. But then they looked at ticks, and there were a lot of different pieces of evidence that showed that they could be involved in this food allergy. And so the first was that the regions of rates with Rocky Mountain spotted fever, which is a disease associated with ticks, was very similar to where people were having reactions to cetuximab. And another thing was that people were recalled having reactions after a tick bite. And then finally, another piece of evidence was that there were similar situations that happened in the past in Australia and Georgia. So the scientists decided to conduct populational studies. They basically asked people from three different populations to conduct a survey, one in Charlottesville, Virginia, and another based on random populations in the US where tick bites were common, and a third group where tick bites were rare. And so in each of these groups, they had a group where people had common anaphylaxis, people had asthma, and just the regular control group. And basically what they did was they analyzed their antibody serum with the ImmunoCAP IgE assays. And this checked for specific and total amounts of IgE antibodies in their system. So after conducting the populational studies, they found several different results. So in this chart, we see that there's a correlation between IgE to alpha gal and IgE to A. americana, which is a species known as the lone star tick. And so what this means was that antibodies against the tick were also correlated with antibodies against alpha gal. So this was something interesting. In this next map, they also found the correlation between the distribution of all these. So in A, in map A, we have those people who are having reactions to cetuximab originally. In map B, we have people with rates of Rocky Mountain spotted fever. And as you can see, it's also very common in southeastern United States. In map C, we also see the same thing, and this is people who are having anaphylaxis to red meat. And in map D, we have the population of the lone star tick. And as you can see, they're all centered around the same location. So this brought up some, this was also interesting. And so during the survey, they also found that people with a higher concentration of alpha gal, of IgE antibodies to alpha gal, were known to have more bites with long-term reactions. However, people with less IgE antibodies for alpha gal reported having no bites. So this suggested a correlation between having tick bites and having antibodies to alpha gal. Yeah.
Back here, it's hard to read the labels. Can you just tell us what the different colors are and what the different bars are?
Okay, so gray, gray is people who had no bites, and then the blue represents people who had bites with short-term reactions, and then the red is people who had bites with long-term reactions.
And the x-axis there, the least amount of IgE to alpha gal is on the left,
yeah.
Right? Okay, great.
So after these populational studies, they had a follow-up, and they monitored three patients for 3 years later who were known to have IgE antibodies for alpha gal. And so they basically monitored their serum before and after tick bites. And so what was interesting was that patients 1 and 3 had reported anaphylaxis, specifically urticaria, which is a form of hives, but patient 2 did not report symptoms, but the patient 2 also had pre-existing allergies. And so based on this chart, we have the three different patients, 1, 2, and 3. And as you can see, there's a parallel nature between the production of IgE antibodies to alpha gal and the total level of IgE antibodies. And so as you can see, after each arrow, which is an instance of a tick bite, there's generally an increase in IgE antibodies for alpha gal. And you can see that in patient 3 as well. So after this instance, they had a sharp increase. And then after this instance, they had another increase. And so the stars represent instances after consuming meat. And that was where they had anaphylactic reactions. But in patient 2, you can see that there's not really a strong correlation between these two. And this is partly because of the fact that patient 2 had pre-existing allergies. So this probably meant that they had a lot of other antibodies, which explains why there's such a big gap between the level of IgE antibodies to alpha gal and their total level. And so in this table, I'd like you to focus on these gray boxes right here. So basically, what these are showing is that after each instance of a tick bite in the 3 patients, which a tick bite is represented by a vertical line, there was an increase in antibodies for the specific substance. So, for example, right here, in April 2002, this patient was known to have 0.51 units of alpha gal antibodies to alpha gal. And so after each vertical line, you can see that these antibody levels generally increase. And these are for alpha gal. And this is also showing a correlation between tick bites and the production of IgE antibodies to alpha gal. And so from this, they made 3 conclusions.
Can you go back to slide?
Yeah.
So also in that gray box, it says beef and I can't read the one above.
Beef and dog epithelium.
So those are also going up?
Yeah, those are just like specific examples of mammal cells that had.
They would have alpha-gal in them.
Okay.
Same mammal cells.
Yeah. Okay.
Is there a reason why they chose to drastically reduce the sample size? Because 3 or really 2 patients seems kind of small.
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure, but I know, like, they could only take, like, they only focused on these 3 subjects because they had, like, it's a pretty, like, generally not a very common occurrence, so I think they just focused on these 3 just to see what was going on.
Yeah. Just to help clarify with that, so they were doing this giant population survey, and then these 3 people happened to have a changed status during their survey. So, you know, not for these people, but for them, it was kind of lucky that they had data for these people before, and then they happened to get these bag tick bites and could get data for them after. So ideally, yes, they want more than 3.
On the table side again, in between January 2008 and February 2010, for the alpha-gal line, it goes from 170 to 14.7. So does that correlate with like some other, did they explore that at all? Because it seems kind of like an anomaly.
So I'm not, yeah, I don't think they really went into it, but I think like after a while, I guess they decreased. I'm not exactly sure about that, but... yeah, then I don't know. That's pretty interesting. I don't know why. So, the 3 conclusions they made were that tick bites were having a correlation with production of IgE antibodies for alpha-gal. And the second conclusion was that these antibodies were related to anaphylaxis after consuming red meat. And the third conclusion was that anaphylaxis to red meat was similar to the distribution of the Lone Star tick population. And so why is this important? Well, with an increasing tick population, it's really important to watch out for ticks because with the warmer climate and deer overpopulation, ticks have more suitable climates, and so therefore they can be in more climates. And basically, as you can see in this map here, the tick population has really increased over the past years. And it's only continuing to increase. And another thing is that having an allergy to meat would be pretty significant, and it would mean that you'd have to completely change your diet. And it would be really difficult to go to this transition really quickly. And with that, I'd say I recommend to always check for tick bites because you never know. And especially if you're in some place where tick bites are prone, especially here in the woods. Yeah. And so, yeah. Thank you.